Hello again. First of all, I want to say that I was pleasantly surprised by the number of people who watched my Nina Simone Zoe Saldana controversy video. Even though I didn't get that many thumbs up, but I didn't expect it either. It is a sensitive topic, I know. I am aware. But I had to express my opinions anyway. Opinion. This time I'm going to talk about something else, but not unrelated. It has something, it is about Charles Barkley and him being made an Uncle Tom for his comments. Anyway, most of you know what happened. And that he said that black people who work hard and educate themselves, get a higher education and a good job, and speak properly without the, you know, ghetto slang and stuff, they are being viewed as a Uncle Toms by other blacks, by the black establishment, so to speak. And he was, of course, he was, this comment was not really taken so well by many black Americans. And he also said that if you don't look like a thug and speak, you know, if you don't sound like you are dumb, then you are not considered a true black person. And you know, I must say that this all sounds quite believable to me, because you know that the fact is that since at least the 90s or late 80s, this culture, this hip hop culture has really been dominant among the African Americans since the 80s, really. And it wasn't really a case before that. It was not such a, it was not considered hip or, you know, trendy to talk like a gangster or a thug. And you know, if you go back to the 70s, you know, these blaxploitation films, you see that they didn't quite talk like that, you know. Those black actors, you know, like they had their own, of course, own special expressions and stuff, but they didn't talk like, hey, what's up, yo, what about, hey, brother, you know, like, hey, my nigga, and that wasn't really, you know. And it's just one of those contradictions, a paradox, I think, that this okay, I think probably even before it was perhaps common in some among some black men there to call each other by that word, the N word, but it wasn't really so widely accepted, you know, as something to, you know, the paradox is that they have made that word like a word that denounces, you know, a black guy, a brother that is, you know, that is like, you know, down, you know, like he's hip, and if you are that, if you are a nigga, then you are, you know, like just a cool cat, you know, one of those acceptable blacks. So it's kind of like a compliment almost to be called that by other blacks. And this is, I believe, one of the things that Barclay meant, you know, that people, black people, don't call themselves that, you know, and who just strive to improve their lives and improve their speech, their dictionary, to put it that way. They are being both mocked and you know, scorned by these urban ghetto, you know, blacks in USA. And even some of them don't live in ghettos. They still consider this hip hop subculture stereotype to be the one that, you know, the acceptable one, you know, that all blacks should strive to be, and you know, Barclay, people like Charles Barclay and some other, you know, black celebrities, people who have made it in life, they have seen, you know, that there is more to life, you know, than just, you know, walking around like this and this and that, dressed in those, you know, what do they call them, sagging, you know, these pants that are, you know what I'm talking about, the sagging pants, and, you know, in a baseball cap and stuff like that, you know. Doing this stuff and trying to look as street as possible, and there is no future in that kind of behavior, because it, of course, it makes you a target for an easy arrest by the cops, you know. It's always these guys that are the targets, those who are most likely to get arrested just because they look like this and talk like this, you know. And of course, nobody likes to get arrested. So anyway, it's just I don't like this kind of today's philosophy. It's just going more and more in a negative direction. It's not just the black youth, I mean, especially when it comes to the youth, it's all youth, all teenagers, especially boys, are trying to be, to live up to this kind of way of life and philosophy that they see in these rap videos, and, you know, they hear these lyrics about people, you know, smacking their bitches and shooting cops and stuff like that, and wearing like gold chains, and and they think that's cool, you know, because everybody else also, or not everybody else, but everybody their age thinks that this is, you know, the way to be, you know, this is this makes you cool, just, you know, simple as that. But then they grow up, they realize, you know, this is just one side of the story, and that this lifestyle is not good for you. But anyway, nowadays it has been so easy to classify someone who does not see things, you know, like these rappers do, and someone who is black and criticize this culture, call it a culture. And I think Charles Barkley was completely right. I mean, everything he said, I can't find a single thing, you know, to okay, it may sound like a bit insulting to these blacks who live in these housing projects and who don't have much of a life. Sometimes they can't choose, you know, they like have this pressure, also peer pressure, to join a gang, you know, live this life. And but at the same time, everyone should strive for a better life, you know, not just give up and say, you know, like, I'm never gonna get a good education, a good job. And this is one other contradiction that these people, like these ghetto blacks, they often complain that they are treated unfairly, and they, you know, say, I'm not able to get a good education or a good job or stuff like that because I'm black. But when they get, when somebody else who is black gets a good education and a good job, they accuse him of selling out, you know, selling his soul, and, you know, becoming white man slave and stuff like that. So that's just, it's just it's just wrong, you know. So, yeah. So I don't know what else to say about this. So anyway, yeah, those were my thoughts. Well, people should learn to think beyond, you know, what they see. You know, you cannot just, you know, like look like 100 yards ahead of you. You know, you have seen everything in your neighborhood, and you say, this is the world, this is, you know, I know, I have seen the world. You can't say that, because there is much more. And when you look past that, you know, when you expand your view, your vision, then you start to realize, you know, perhaps this is not all, perhaps there is another truth to life. Well, I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. You must learn to see past just what's in front of you, you know. So in that way you will discover the truth, and you will see what you need to do with your life and what you need to change about your life and yourself. And that's the problem. Many of these people who blast Charles Barkley for being an Uncle Tom, they don't see past what's in front of them or just ahead of them. They can't see longer than that, unfortunately. But he can, fortunately. Yeah, that was all for now. So I hope at least some of you will think constructively and learn to see, in 3D, not 1 or 2D. So good luck with that.